It works. It works. Oh, I'm streaming in 720. Why is that?
It works.
It works. It's fine. I'll let it ride. Okay. Yeah. I guess I'll play this album before anybody gets here. See what it is. Well, that was loud. Loud. Second. Yeah, we'll try it, I guess. So I think there's a problem with these panels that prevents me from using them. I'm trying to remember what it is. I mean, aside from the excessive number of attachment points. For now. Did that correctly. Something that is facing forward on the front should also be facing forward on the rear. I just had to find a suitable thing to try. Well, it's not gonna be any good, is it? Good old battery. Okay, I guess that's sort of proof. Not the proof I was looking for. Hang on. Yes, okay. So apparently I put the top side down somehow. Great. Or that's just the battery's natural behavior? Nope, that is definitely the top. Sigh. Okay. Okay, never mind then. There we go. Just put it back the way it was. Leave it alone. Where are you, liquid? Actually, let's put you on the center. It looks like the manipulation tool is not centered longitudinally along this part. It doesn't look right at all. I need to get in close and take a look at this. measure you. So you stick one over on the edge. There we go, like that. I don't care about vertical. Yeah, okay, see that? That is centered, but you look at the tool, and the tool is... Maybe it is centered. It's really hard to tell. Whatever. I have aura on it now, so that's fine. Okay. That might be okay. That might be okay. People, why did it say this was posted a week ago? Dude, I'm done answering for YouTube. Don't even get me started. YouTube has never respected my channel, and I'm done giving any respect to YouTube. That's basically the long and short of it. Cool. I think that looks cool. Give it a bit of a sweep to it, but come on, come on, come on, come on. Short one could be workable. Then we go with a long one. I don't have any choice. There's nothing else I could put on there that would look appropriate in that spot. Nothing has any better crash tolerance. I could try a fairing. No, fairing is 9 meters per second. Never mind. I don't know. I'm just not a fan of those shapes, but I don't think I have any alternative. Yeah, we'll leave it. Okay, so in case you guys haven't figured out by now, I am once again working on one of my oldest projects in KSP, which is to make a sea-traveling ferry with a retractable ramp. And the ramp is what is going to be happening next. I haven't touched KSP in, jeez, I don't even know, a couple weeks, it feels like. It's probably since the holiday thing. Yeah, whatever. You know what, I could probably do a static ramp right there. Save me a little bit of time, maybe. Actually, kind of like that little triangle there. I might be able to use that. Oops, no, wrong button, wrong button. also not centered front to back. Oh no, that's just the texturing. These are largely redundant, but kind of like them being there anyway. Nah, you have enough charge, you're fine. Just go with that. Those a little bit higher off the water, actually. Yeah, that should be okay. Okay, let's go see if it floats. Yeah, I need to do some strutting, that's okay. Do strutting later. I have no idea if I have KSP sounds turned on, so brace yourself for excessively loud water impact noises. I don't have sound, oh, okay. Good. Good, good, good. I'm concerned about how much these slants are going to create drag. Oh, creating a lot of downforce there. Oh, that's gonna be really bad. Oh, that is really bad. Oh, do not like that at all. Not happy I am. It's a lot of drag, a lot of pitch force. No, that's not cool, that's not cool. Why is everything that looks cool ends up breaking the game? Try holding it while it's not snap parts. Yes, I know. I'm gonna mute my mic for a minute. Okay. I think there's no more noise in the background. One second. Ow! Yeah, alright, we're all set. I might need to... might need to get up and let the dog back in a minute. Yeah, exactly, Sam. Because I don't know about you guys, but I as sure as bleepity bleeping bleep do not have 40 bleeping grand to pay per video on my channel approaching 700 videos. What is the math on that anyway? I'm gonna round down for generosity. It's like something like that is the fine. It's probably like 42 grand. I don't know. Yeah, sorry, but I personally do not have 26.5 fucking million dollars to pay the goddamn government for goddamn bullshit. I don't have $26 million. I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not going to get targeted by COPPA. I do everything I can to stay under their radar. Okay, that's obviously not going to work. That's obviously not going to work. Wow, that's just crap. I'm serious. If I get some notice in my YouTube inbox telling me COPPA is coming after me, I'm leaving the country. I'm fleeing the country. Non-extradition country, here I come. I'm not even joking. I'm not going to stick around for that. Not happening. I will leave family. I will leave everything I have. I am fleeing the country if that shit comes at me. God damn it, YouTube. All looks ugly. What the heck? I should just give up on trying to make this look good. Authority limits. Let's drop you down to like 5 degrees of deflection. Yeah, whatever. Okay, the whole reason I started making this was so I could practice my deployable ramp designs without having to start touching the ramp. But honestly, there's no point in working on a ramp if you don't have a platform that can carry the ramp effectively. So that's why I'm wasting time trying to build a boat that might actually float. I do apologize for the delays on my crap entertainment. I should shut down this channel. I really should. But here's the thing. Like, I got into... Okay, little bit of backstory. Hang on, before I go on a backstory rant, let me catch up on chat. Elon Musk? World War III, yeah, right? Exactly. Okay, so a little bit of backstory. If anybody's watching who doesn't already know, I got into YouTube. I became a YouTube creator. I transitioned from being a consumer to a creator over 6 years ago. Probably closer to 7 years now. With the intention of helping people. Like, I was playing this game, Kerbal Space Program. I've been playing it since the start of this channel. And I saw a bunch of people doing things on YouTube that they seemed to have trouble with. Or when I tried looking for help on things, I found that there was nobody who would address certain issues, certain methods of gameplay. So I decided to explore those methods myself and post, you know, share my results to the world. So I got into this, I made this channel start producing gameplay content to help people. And I've never asked for money. This channel has never once been monetized. I've not made a single penny from anything I put on YouTube. But if I had known from the very start, you know, if YouTube had been responsible and come to terms with the COPPA legislation from the beginning, I probably wouldn't be here right now. I would never have bothered trying to be a creator. Because I think this channel started back in 2014, I want to say, and the COPPA finagle, whatever made-up verb you want to use, whatever YouTube did to get in trouble with COPPA, happened back in 2013, before my channel really kicked off. So if YouTube had done the responsible thing and notified its potential content creators that there was going to be a crap storm in 2020, I never would have started this channel. The other reason that I decided to start posting stuff on YouTube was to basically serve as a... I'll just let this play out. Was to serve as a repository for various things that I wanted to save on the internet, you know, videos that I had made, videos that I had found, things I wanted to save for posterity. Basically, YouTube became my cloud storage for videos. That is effectively what I have used YouTube for in a lot of cases. I have some private videos of music that I'd like to try to use at some point in the future, saved on here, just as a reminder of where they are. I have all of I have about half of my flight training videos uploaded to YouTube. I need to get back on that. Basically, YouTube is a personal memoir. It's a personal memoir of video footage. YouTube is my cloud storage. I'm not going to upload gigabytes worth of video to some cloud saving website that has a limit on how much storage space you can have. Heck no. I'm going to take advantage of Google's monopoly, and remember, YouTube started independently from Google, then Google bought YouTube, but I'm going to take advantage of Google's monopoly on the digital frontier of America and, you know, use their infinite storage space, basically. So YouTube is my cloud storage. YouTube is my cloud storage for videos. So it's not just about helping people, it's not just about sharing knowledge, it's also about, hey, you know, I'm an internet user, I need some place to store my crap. And I'd kind of like this channel to stick around. But if YouTube is going to come down on me, or not YouTube themselves, but if the people enforcing COPPA are going to come down on me for having a YouTube channel that is used for those two things, number one, helping people with video games, number two, using YouTube for cloud storage because, hey, it's free. I mean, if they're going to come down on me for that, screw all you guys, I'm out. I'm out of the country. I'm gone. Extradition or suicide, one of those two things is going to happen, because I'm not paying $26 million to nobody. I know that was a double negative, I'm sorry. I'm not going to put up with that crap. Start working the ramp. The time coming in to show over and under in its course. If anybody is curious, this music is from a musical group called Delirium. They're quite old. They were big in the 90s and the early 2000s. I have more of their albums than most other artists. And I just found all their CDs in my little travel case that I used to be carrying around in my car. I was like, oh, hey, here it is. So I thought I'd put this on for a little bit. Although there are only three tracks on this little sample EP, I need to switch over to one of the actual albums before much longer. So you guys are probably getting bored with this music. Now, this isn't actually going to happen like this. I'm not going to have something directly attached. I'm not going to have a surface directly attached to the piston, but I just want to have some sort of a visual measurement before I go much further to make sure this is going to be viable in dimensions. Don't really want it to be too far out either. I could get away with that. I don't think it would look too bad. Yeah, I think I can get away with that. Okay, so then I just need to have the interior cross-threaded. Excuse me, that should be sufficient. Okay. As far as the length of it, I think that's where we need a hinge to be on these things. Do I want plus? No, let's flip it. There we go, so negative is down. And let's have you shift over to there. Okay, and I'll deal with the hinge dimensions later. Actually, I should probably deal with them now. Terrible. That is going to be utterly terrible. I'm going to need another one. Whoa, camera, come back. Doable, depending on the steepness of the beach. So 14 is as low as we can go without running into something. I'm not even sure this is going to be finalized. I don't even know if I want it to be that far out. I kind of wanted to use that slope as a structural support, which would have worked fine if the ramp had started back here. I might change that. I hate these things, I'll just get rid of them. They're pointless. Nothing about this is making me happy. This is all wrong. Oh, this is all wrong. Alright, I don't thought you guys were getting tired of the music. Let's switch over and check up on chat here. Let's see which one of them is. We have been listening to Firefly, so I should probably play the album that the actual Firefly song appeared on. I think it's this one. Okay, Stoppe. El Stoppo. Oh yes, physical media, ladies and gentlemen. That's how old I am. I still listen to music on physical media. Music. Here we go. Iran? What? Cape Town. Yeah, I'll come sleep in your spare bedroom, Jerry. Just had a wacky idea. Goodbye, Pistons. Screw the ramp. We're going with the crane. Oh yeah! We're doing it. We're going with the crane. We're going with the crane. As I go. Sorry, hang on. 0.8 tons. I'm going to have to balance it out on the other side. Why do I still have this open? Alright. No, wait, where are the large hinges? Is that seriously the largest hinge I can get? Really? Oh, hang on. Maybe I'm overboarding this. Yeah. So what are we up to now? 014 times 3 plus, okay. 4 times 3, 0.66. And the reason I'm recording the mass is so I can offset it on the other side with a conning tower. To the next size, maybe. What am I looking for? Oh, a rotator. I need another rotator because I feel like I need another rotator. Boom, 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 boom. a rotator and a hinge on the bottom. That's what I need. That's what I'm looking for. Another rotator. And a... Wait, is that right? Uh-oh. Oh, shoot. I can never remember these things. I think that's correct. Another rotator and another hinge. This is really going to be straining, though. And then finally, the claw. Wow, that's really oversized. Ish. Oh well. Okay, so that was another 075. 0.2 and 0.26. Okay, so 0.02, 0.026, 0.075. Fraser crane? What? Why would I call it Fraser crane? I mean, I know who the character is, but how does Fraser fit into the crane? I'm confused. Okay, say this is C. Actually, I'm gonna say this is 2A. So I'm going with a completely different mechanism for transport. Okay, so altogether, what was that? That was, .14 times 3 plus... .1.2? Oh, that's easy to offset. Because this thing, wait, no, hang on. This thing weighs 1.28, but I think if I take out the modern propellant, it goes down to 1.2. So that is easy peasy. Mono gone. And it gives me a ready-made cockpit. Cool. With the hatch below the deck, which is not cool. Oh well. Let's embrace it. This is the stupidest looking thing ever. I want to put somebody in there. Just to test it. See how badly they die. Wait for the percussion drop. Percussion drop is coming. Ooh. Need to hear that again without my interruptions. Extendable piston is producing noticeable drag. Everything else seems to be okay. It's not terrible. This thing... producing a little bit, but not enough to worry about. Oh, maybe it is, actually. So the claw and the main piston are producing some drag, but not so much that we can't overcome it. Yeah, it's not really causing us to drift that quickly. It's doable. We're still maintaining almost 67 MPS, so I'm okay with that. Oh yeah, hang on. We'll just switch on reverse engines. Come on, come on, come on, get down there. Boom. Alright. Can Jeb get out? Oh my god, he can. Below decks. Jeb, you maniac. Hang on, can I just move you out? Yeah, let me just move you up. Alright, drop. Yay! Alright, Jeb is on decks. Let's pick him up. Oh yeah, I need different electricity for this, because I don't have any means of sustaining these robotics. Okay, so to start with... This would take a very, very long time to do. Oh dear, this would take a long time to do. Wait, I want 84, please. 84. There you go. I almost wonder if I could just release the motors on these things so they dangle. On power loss, free. Motor disengaged. Ooh, that's not bad. Sort of. Oh, maybe not. Okay, so there we go. Kind of over, Jeb. Sort of. Kind of. I'll say yes. Now we're over him. Okay, so now engage the claw. Oh, the poor dude has no idea what's coming. Alright, come on, let's do a Danny, whatever his number is, 2467 kind of breaking of the game. Oh, Jeb's jumping, he's getting ready. He's getting ready for takeoff. Smooshed. Wee. That was so unnecessary. Oh, this looks sweet and jib around now. I'm so sorry. Oh, I can crank up the traverse rate too. Tone down the damping. Oh, Jeb is really gonna fly now. Hang on, we really need to take advantage of this. Sorry. Okay, motor disengaged. Let's disengage all the motors. Alright, now this should be pretty good. Let's also... yeah, that one's okay. That one should be okay. Alright, let's really give him a spin. I'm sorry, Jeb. It's for science! Robotics parts are great. Wow. Oh, man. The saddest part of that was it actually worked. It actually worked. Alright, but clearly I don't need these bottom two. They're not really doing anything. That was ridiculous. Actually, no, hang on. I do think I want a hinge. I don't need the rotator, but I do need the hinge. Yeah, I do still need the hinge down there. In case I'm trying to pick up something that's up high. There we go. Okay. Alright, yeah, aside from Jeb's egress problems, that went pretty well. Sure. The claws, yes, the air gate claws. Have you ever used the making straight swords without fairing? Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Those things are... If you can get those to launch. hang on, what am I... Oh, there's a lot of stuff I need to catch up on. Because it's a crane. Okay. Other kinds of modern rover, clearly some timber. I mean, it can be. I've used it before. Well, it's sort of a holdover from back in the day. Back when the Mark I cockpit used to look cool. Black Ops 3 Zombies. I'm sure Black Ops does not work on my computer. Cyber, I am using... I'm making a water carrier vehicle. It's not intended to carry aircraft, though. Modern prop for space planes. Does the arm look like one of those mechanical punching arms? Oh, yeah. Have you guys seen a mechanical punching arm? I'm doing a low-tech run, and I don't have fairings yet. Every time I use a Soyuz pod, my rockets suffer from spinning rocket syndrome. So true! Okay, yeah, I guess I could use some cheering. I mean, cheering is pretty fickle with me. So I should probably put on an actual cargo and do some weight tests, see how much mass this crane can support. It's kind of annoying that you jump from a massive diameter piston like this down to a tiny narrow diameter piston like this, and there's no middle ground there. It's really difficult. Woo! Oh yeah, let's pilot the ship like that. That's a great idea. But he's above ground. Anyway. Okay, so I did just save that. Let's take a quick look at the robot punching arm. If anybody hasn't seen that yet, I think it's kind of funny. Where the hell did I put it? Robot punch. Sure. Play! Punch! Yeah. I'm missing a rotator. This thing needs to have a second servo up here. Either second servo or second hinge, I haven't figured out what exactly. Because it's not covering, the shoulder joint is not covering all three axes of the ball bearing rotation properly. So that's why the arm sort of like levitates up at the end, like right here. It's elevating more than it should. It should be thrusting out instead of lifting up. So the single servo in the back of trying to raise the entire assembly is not being anatomically correct. So it was a prototype. I'll take what I can get, but anyway, that's, yeah. Back to the ferry. Okay, mass test. Let's see how much this thing can actually pull or lift. Yeah, so we have these two large diameter pistons and then two small diameter pistons, and it's kind of annoying. We can't do anything more. I already have all the motor sizes increased or set at max by default. That is default setting, so whatever this can do, that is all it can do. does that not look centered? What is wrong with my eyes? Because it isn't centered. Okay. Hey, look at that. Sprite physics, come on, let go. Let go of my RAM. Let go of my RAM. God. It's really sad the KSP-1 has just been abandoned. There's so much left to do to fix and improve this game. It's really sad. Don't think this arm can go down that far. Oh, maybe it can. Oh, no, it's fine. It's fine. Okay. Cool. Swing you back a little bit. Maybe a little bit more. Sure. Yeah, we'll go with that. I do want you to be a little bit closer to the center, though, if possible. Grab. Hey! Whoa! Oh! Alright! Oh, that hinge is not happy! That is a very, very unhappy hinge. Aim camera. Oh, man. Oh, he's like, you want me to lift? What? Oh, dude. Oh, he's struggling. Oh, I'm sorry. Oh, hang on. Hang on. Wait, are we literally not able to pull that up because it's of conflicts? Oh, we literally can't lift it. We're not allowed to. Oh. Whoops! Oh, that's... that's gonna be problematic for getting vehicles off of the ship. Okay, hang on. I have a solution for this. No, the claw. I'm trying to get the claw. You bugger. I need to put this on action group. Oi! There we go. Disarm. Holy mackerel. What? Seriously? Now you're stuck? Arm. Release. Disarm. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. You're being ridiculous. You're just being ridiculous. Really? Really? You got yourself trapped on the ship. The claws are disengaged, but they can't retract through the floor. Wow. Okay, hang on. There are a couple of solutions I have for this. And TVC? Thrust vectoring control? The upper stage. Guys in your career modes. I'm not on Reddit. Okay. So, a couple of solutions. Number one, make the arm claw thing be same interaction as the vessel. Make all the panels be same interaction. This could take a while. I'll just make the ones nearest to the docking port. And should it cover those guys as well? Yes, it does. Okay. So that's one solution. The other solution is to jettison this off the side of the ship and then pick it up and deposit it onto the deck. We'll try the solution first, though. And I have not heard the dog in a suspiciously long while, so I'll be right back for just a moment. Enjoy the music, y'all. Don't ask me what accent that was. Sorry about that. I had not heard the dog in a while, and since the garage was recently used, right at the start of the stream, I wanted to make sure that the dog had not been caught outside, because it is snowing outside, and I don't want to be accused of animal cruelty. Alright. She has very long fur, so she's fine. She would be fine outside in the snow. She actually wants to go outside right now, but I'm like, I can't go out. I'm streaming. I can't go outside with you right now. I mean, I could just shut the stream down. Nobody's really going to be bothered if I stop the stream, I'm sure. Whoa, shake, rattle, and roll. I'm just gonna let you be alone like that. I'm starting to get the sense that this hinge isn't really useful for anything unless I'm trying to reach up high. Here, let me just let this dangle for a second. Ooh, going down, 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 down. More. Maybe not that much. Okay. Can you imagine being a crane operator on one of those shipping yards? I mean, that is going to be a stressful job. The amount of money that is in cargo shipping, the value of some of the goods that get transported, like supercars, and there you are, an underpaid crane operator. Running some gigantic piece of machinery that you hope has been well maintained. I can't even imagine that kind of life. That has got to be a stressful job. Alright, don't drop this multi-million dollar thing or we're going to take it out of your paycheck. That's where you just laugh and walk away. I resign? You will never get that out of my paycheck unless you start paying me like 10 times what you're paying me now. Okay, I think we're ready for this. Let's try it again. Hopefully. Hopefully it does not sink below decks again. Plop. Oh, hey, worked the claw. Yes, good job, claw. Good job. Nope, bad claw. 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 Oh, you got stuck again, didn't you? You got stuck on the stupid deck panels. Dang it, claw. Why? Let go. All right, I guess that kind of works. Sure. Oh, hey, we could do an extension test. Wait, why am I not on the servo and me? Oh, because it dropped to the command module. But Jeb's still in here, so technically he's now operating the crane. That's fine. I guess we don't need it to be quite over there. Okay, let's go to maximum extension on this just so we could get some kind of idea of our reach. Oh yeah, that would be a problem. That would be a problem. The farthest we can reasonably operate. Trying to test the corners of the ship here. Farthest we could reasonably operate is in kind of a semicircle like this, going up to the cockpit. So, five panels. These five panels along the crane side by the base. 5, 3, 1. That's kind of our reach. Maybe I need two cranes. Well, so far we haven't proven that the crane is actually worthwhile yet. Just kind of sad. One thing I would like to try is doing a water pickup, though. So let me move this into reach. Alright. Music's gone all quiet again. Quiet and moody. Okay, actually I got struck once, but... Wait, struck by... Wait, hang on. What did I miss? You got struck by what now? You got struck by an SRB? I missed something. Trinity and the drive launches. Tune escape trajectory. Scared this is just sad. Yes. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, it's funny. Well, not it's funny for outsiders and not funny for people living there, but it's funny for outsiders watching traffic reactions to snow in places where it doesn't usually snow. One of the jobs I used to work at, it was a company that was split into several different locations around the country, and the headquarters was in like the mid-latitudes of the American Eastern Seaboard. And me up here in Vermont, you know, winter snow was no big deal. But down there, they almost never see snow. So some of our coworkers who lived or who operated at the headquarters were telling us about a small snowstorm that they got there. It's like a half inch of snow, but it caused traffic accidents and pileups for miles all over the state. It's crazy. People just don't know what to do with it. They can't imagine how badly vehicles behave when they lose traction with the ground. Forklift operators, yeah. I used forklifts a little bit in one of my earlier jobs. Oh, ouch. Ooh. Ooh. See the video where a forklift operator destroyed a whole warehouse? Was this intentional? That sounds like an intentional thing, because a forklift is not that large a machine. Warehouse dominoes. Oh, maybe it wasn't intentional. Ooh, yeah, anyway. The loading dock accident videos, those are pretty bad. Even when nobody gets hurt, it's just like, oh, that's gonna cost some money, you know? Okay, can you actually help me cycle the arming? Disarm. Rearm. We're a little bit off. Can you give me just another couple degrees here? Nope, maybe. Okay. And deploy. Uh-oh, we're reaching the limits of our extension here. Hang on, let me retract you just a smidge. Okay. Zoink. Hey, we got it! Look at that! Hey! Amazing. Shamazing. Whoa. Oh, we're taking on inertia here. I don't know if that's the correct physics term. Hang on, let me release this. On parallels free, motor free. Come on, pull it up, clear the water. Oh, the ship is listing. Come on, you could do it. I am a crane! Oh god, look, it's stretching. It's stretching the joints. Oh man. Whoo! Alright, you are disengaged. That's good. Let's put a little bit. Actually, hang on. Ideally, a crane operator would do these simultaneously. I want to extend the piston but retract the hinge so that the object doesn't collide with the hull. Or itself, ideally. Okay. Now this should actually have a slow traversal rate and quite a bit of damping. Nice and easy. Nice and easy. Okay. Target angle. Oh, whoa, no, not again! What the heck? What the heck was that? It's like the tank just voluntarily dropped through the floor. It's like it was pulled down. It just sort of magnetized itself down through the floor. What the heck, man? Okay. Alright, so crane's not gonna work. That's my verdict. Crane's not going to work. You know, I'm thinking there's a reason I've been working on this project for 6 years and still haven't found a successful solution. Yeah. Right. Ooh. Dude, have you, this is a couple of decades old now, but I'm curious to know what the status of the Colorado River is, because like almost a couple of decades ago there was a video, National Geographic or something like that, that was talking about how the Colorado River no longer reaches the ocean because Las Vegas consumes all of the water coming from the Colorado River. And I'm wondering, I mean, there's got to be a finite limit of how much Las Vegas can expand. Adios, Fraser. Goodbye, Fraser the Crane. What are you doing with those crane boats? Not much at the moment. I mean, I was playing around with it. The whole idea here, the whole premise of building this watercraft at all, is because ever since I started playing KSP, I've been trying to make a water-going vessel that can transport other craft without resorting to mods. And granted, the robotics parts come from an expansion, but since the expansion was officially released, I don't consider it to be a mod. It's just a DLC. It's just an expansion. So for 6 years, maybe longer, I've been trying to make a ferry with various implements, and I thought the solution would be readily available with robotics, but so far it's not. So far it is not. Anyway, here's Firefly that we listened to earlier in the stream. Doom, 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 doom. Doom, 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 doom. Boom, 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 boom. Yeah, so I'm stumped. Not stumped, but discouraged, because this wasn't the dream solution that I was hoping for. How long has this stream been going for? Over an hour. Okay. I've already done the whole propeller thing. Like trying to use robotics parts for underwater propulsion. It doesn't work. They just don't produce thrust. They're programmed. They are programmed to not produce thrust. So traditional methods of using elevons are actually your better bet if you want to try to use underwater propellers, but I'm not going to take the time to build those right now. Paddle wheels as well. Paddle wheels will work. But you get very slow speeds with either of those, so that's why I'm sticking with the Junos. Or not the Junos, the jet engines. So yeah, the only solution that this boat still needs is a means to get vehicles on and off of the transport deck. The crane didn't work. The ramp could work, but it takes a lot of finagling, which I wasn't prepared for. I was unprepared for the stream. What else? I could try using a VTOL, but VTOLs are just so finicky. I am not Cupcake Landers. I can't pilot a VTOL for to save my life. Like having a VTOL come in here with an arm claw and VTOL this tank off of the deck, instead of relying on something that's attached to the hull. But that's just really, really dangerous. That's just asking for parts to be broken, vehicles to be destroyed. Also it requires a lot of fuel. I mean, what else can I use though? I suppose I could use a sled. Like an electric sled that has a really low. Hey, I'll try to build what I'm describing. Yeah, let's get rid of the tank. I'll actually use this platform. Okay, so basically, wait, come on, come on, come on, come on. Stop being stubborn. Like that, right? Just, you have a wheeled sled that drives around on deck, and then something can drive onto that. And then when you get to the edge, the vehicle itself, or the sled itself, goes through the trouble of trying to get on and off of the ship. Maybe it has some extendable wheels, maybe it has its own arm pieces, its own robotics to try to like reach down like a spider or something, try to extend some legs down and crawl itself off the ship if necessary. That way you avoid the issue of having a ramp, which is a lot of parts, and doesn't really want to sit well on the ferry, and tends to cause a lot of drag. But then the sled is a single point of failure. You know, if you break a piece of your ramp, that's not a critical issue as long as the vehicle is narrow enough that it can use whatever remains on the ramp to try to shimmy itself up onto the vehicle. But if you lose wheels or legs on a sled, you know, once the sled is gone, you're done. You're done with your transport method. I don't know. There are solutions, but they are all so massively part intensive, part count intensive. I was really wanting a low part count solution, but it's not happening today. So, I'm putting this stream in your guys' court. What do you want me to do for the next, like, half hour or so? What do you want me to make? I saw people talking about career mode craft. Maybe I could do something. Some small, lightweight career mode stuff. Steals wrench, yeah, I didn't imagine so. Does still have the south of this? Yeah, I imagine so. It's like yeah. Wanna have cars that tow things onto the boat? Ooh, hang on, wait, how would they tow? I like that idea, but how would they tow? I don't have any mods that do ropes or cables or anything like that. So how would that work? How would you attach a tow rope? What would the tow rope consist of? I did do that tank tread thing a while back. But that's also very part intensive. Where is it? Tank tread. Hull camera. Oh, I don't have a hull camera installed. Strange. Yeah, this is also a lot of parts. I can have like a conveyor belt that pulls things onto the ferry. But then whatever I'm pulling would have to have compatible interlinks to be pulled. Unless the tread itself was just ginormous, it could support large weights. I don't know. So docking ports hold this place, so you need a Soyuz pod into orbit with only 1.25 meter parts and no fairings, no vector engines either. Use a grabbing arm to attach the car to the cargo. Right, but that still requires a ramp, doesn't it? So you were saying something similar to the sled idea, but having the sled go under the cargo, it becomes just a tug car. Like a, I don't know, a forklift or something. But yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, but you still have to have a ramp. The boat itself would still have to have the ramp. Anyway, okay. Okay, so Soyuz things. We got the onion. Onion's just the one person, isn't it? Yeah, this is gonna be crazy. Of course, getting into space to begin with. Hang on, let me switch over to. Hang on. I'm gonna switch over to Vab. Getting something into space in the first place takes a certain amount of delta V that I tend to forget because I don't do these things very often. on, I did that out of order. Oops. Is that centered? I don't think so. Oh, my eyes. Dang it, why am I not able to see things? I do need new glasses, but that's not the issue. Just like, my perception of distances is really off for some reason. Okay, yeah, it needs to go down even more. Wow. Okay. Crazy. Not that it matters. I mean, it really doesn't matter where the where the decoupler thing is. Oh, whoops. It's not even on centered. Whatever. Whatever, whatever, whatever. Oh, I heard a dog harumph at me. There's a dog harumphing. Yeah, I hear you harumphing. What, do you need to go out or something? Is that what you need? Yeah, you need to go out? I can't go outside with you right now, but I can let you out if you want to. Well, I can't come out with you right now. Maybe in a few minutes. Alright, I'll be right back, guys. Let me, remind myself what I'm doing. Engines, engines, engines. That's what we're here for. Okay, be right back.
Need to go out? Okay, I can let you out. Yes, you can go out if you want. Yes, you can go out.
Whoops. I didn't think that through, did I? Yeah, I really didn't think that through at all. Oh. Of course, I already forgot who challenged me to do this. I think it was Sam. But even doing this, I'm using parts that probably aren't available in career mode. Like, I think we're stuck with these in early career mode, if you even have those. So I'm probably cheating a little bit. Yeah, we'll give this a shot. Okay. Stage. Check on chat before I launch. No entry. Oh, you do? Oh. Plus black frames too? Yes, of course they do. Obviously. I mean, what choices do you have? It's black, silver, or brown. Those are your choices for prescription glasses. I mean, the optometrist does not really give you a whole lot of flair to select from. Tells me it's not blonde. No, my brother was born with blonde hair. Yeah, it's certainly not bleached by the sun. We could appreciate that. You know, the eagle nose cones are long fuel tanks. Oh! Or reaction wheels. Oh. Ugh. My distaste for this project is increasing exponentially. Let's just give this a try. Let's see if this can work with the advanced tech. Of course, this is now relying on my piloting skills, which are very much out of practice. I should probably turn on game sound. So we can enjoy the rocket. That's a lot of things. I don't have any SRBs, do I? It's a pity. Went really fast, too. I'm being a little bit aggressive with this turn. Let's slow that down. Yeah, I'm about 600 meters altitude ahead of myself. Let's slow that down. Relax. There's no rush here. There we go. Getting back on track. Oh, it is starting to go. Ooh, something is not happy on here. We are approaching some aerodynamic pressures that are not too happy with us right now. Okay, that was a frightening moment. Wowzers. Okay, let's just hold it here. We're like 3 kilometers low. Oh, look at that drag line coming off of the capsule. It's longer than the tail flame! The heck, Soyuz? Dang, dude! Guys, like a kite tail in the front of a ship! Oh, too fast. Slow that down. Slow. There we go, I think we're getting back under control. We're high atmosphere, so the drag is no longer an issue, really. Okay, let's start getting aggressive again with the turn. Alright, where are we? Oh, actually looking pretty good. Looking pretty good. Alright, let's punch this. Going for 100. There we go. Are we clear? Yes, we are. I think I'm a little bit early. Actually, no, it seems to be right on time. I think we're doing okay. Wait for the camera flip. There it is. All right, good. Not bad. Okay, so that was doable, and we had enough delta V, which makes me happy. Plenty of delta V, actually. So let's try to downgrade the tech to whatever we're working with in career mode at this point. Okay, so who was this? Yeah, Sam is the one doing it. Diamond needle nose guns are long fuel tanks. Okay, so we gotta increase part count. Decrease some of these. I think the dog just opened the door to the outside. So we have the fins, that's not a problem. We don't have the nose cones, we don't have the reaction wheels. Hey, Sam, do you have the small reaction wheels? Yes, you do. Okay. Radially mounted batteries. Yeah, they do. And you, oh, and you don't have fuel lines? What? Oh, that sucks. Okay, this is gonna hurt. This is gonna hurt. Oh, do you have both of these engines? Do you have the Radial 45s and the Reliant 30s? Do you have both of those? Do you have struts? Oh, this is gonna be a pain. Ay ay ay. You don't have those either. Holy crap, we're basically starting over. Okay. Think for a second. You do, however, have the small reaction wheels. Do you have any kind of service bay? Like, do you have the starting service bay? Is that available to you? Because if it is, that would be fantastic. If not, that's okay. We'll work around it. I don't want to do this. Sure. Okay, little note on the song that we're listening to now. It has some background voice, you know, something taken from a movie or something, or a documentary, and the delivery is really creepy because of the music that Delirium created for this track. But if you actually listen to the audio, he's just talking about something completely banal. Is it this track or is it the next one? I don't know, it's... whatever. Delirium used to do some really creepy music. I loved it. It was awesome. They did some amazingly, deliciously creepy stuff in their earlier albums. And then they went all happy and fluffy like they are now. A nose cone, huh? Don't know how I feel about the nose cone. I'm not really on board with the nose cone. It would probably look okay. Look, come on. It's not look okay at all. Do you even have the onion pot? Hey, Sticky Missions. I was building something else earlier in the stream, but right now I'm basically taking on a challenge from Sam to build a rocket that can get this really aerodynamically annoying onion pod up into space, up into low carbon orbit, without completely flipping out in the atmosphere on its way up. That is the challenge. I do have swivels and reliance. I don't use... that's fine. You don't have fuel lines or struts. Jeez. You must be really early in your career mode, Sam. Ouch. Okay. I'm going to assume that you have the service bay. I'm making that assumption on your behalf. Because I want it, darn it. I need service bays. I need them now. Okay, let me extrude this out a little bit. Actually, no, that should be okay. That should be okay. We could do a little ball. Okay, I don't remember how many I need. I think I only need 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 should be fine. Alright. Maybe not even 8. Maybe it's less than that. We'll see. I'm going to do a torque ball. This is an idea that I posed to Veos for one of the early naval iterations of the interdrive. Actually, no, it wasn't for the interdrive. It was for... He was doing some North Pole challenge. Oh, I only needed 6. Shoot, I only needed 6. Dang it. Okay, start over. He was doing some North Pole challenge, and I made some stock engines that used torque balls like this. That's what it was. But they were using the large size. Like these size things, I made a torque ball out of these parts, the large parts, and turned them into some propeller engines and sent a plane to the North Pole using low-tech Solar Nations part stuff. I think he liked it. I never saw him attempt to recreate it, though. It's probably like, hell no, enter. Hell no. Oh, shoot, I lost track of the orientation. I think that's okay. There we go. We got ourselves a torque ball. Okay. So, do you have the service base? Yes, you do have the service base. Awesome possum. Okay. Yeah, right. Is he using shortcuts for place movement? Yes. Yes, I am. I believe the defaults are number 1, 2, 3, and 4 on your keyboard. As opposed to functions. They're just the plain number keys. 1, 2, 3, 4. It's like exclamation point, at sign, number signed, dollar sign. Yeah, I'm using shortcuts. Is that a problem? Should I be using mouse? I'm sorry. Okay, so you do have the service base. We're cool with that. I need to put parachutes back onto here now that I removed them. Probably don't need the extra torque thing up here. Excuse me. This stupid little hat. It's like a hat. That's what it is. It's a hat. It's a little hat. It looks so bad. Alright, we're going to go with radials. It's going to be a rough landing for Jeb. Jeb's going to have a hard radial landing. Drogue chute, that's what I was trying to say, not radial. Drogue is what I was trying to say, but yes, they are drogue. Radial drogue chutes. Jeb, I'm sorry. Touchdown's going to be a pain. Brace your spine. Okay, I'm feeling cold. I think the dog did leave the door open.
Door's not open.
Amazing. She must still be outside then. So, like, what I do is I leave the door just lightly shut so she can push it open with her nose. But the draft just sweeps through the house, and I thought I was starting to feel the beginnings of a draft. Alright, so you don't have the long tanks, you only have the short ones. Okay, this is gonna be... Ay, 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 man. That's right, I need to put batteries back in here because I took them out. That's fine. I don't know why I'm trying to make this look pretty. It's just a tech test. Let's go with that, I guess. Okay, and then we'll put this back on at long last. Okay, so no fuel lines, no struts, no large reaction wheels, no nose cones, no angled nose cones. Sam, this is gonna be painful. Like... Dude, I would just be giving up by now. Okay. Finally back to where we started. We're getting close to where we started. Okay, so the reason... Let me explain my engine choice down here at the bottom. The LV-T30 Reliant, or what I call the 30. Just the 30. 30 and 45. The 30 Reliant, it has much better ISP. well, not much better, but significantly better ISP. And because it's the main, the upper stage booster, basically, because I guess this is the circularization stage. Actually, we don't even need that much fuel, do we? We didn't before. Hang on. I'm editing the rocket on the fly. Okay. So we have the circularization stage with the 909 Terrier. The upper stage booster is the 30 Reliant, and that's because it has better ISP and such. But the reason I'm okay with having it on the core column of fuel tanks is because it's going to come into play. It's going to come into its own when we're in the upper atmospheres, where aerodynamic drag is not going to be such a big deal and don't need thrust vectoring to keep the thing on track. During the lower stages, when we're doing our pretty hefty gravity turns and trying to stay on track with not a whole lot of aerodynamic pressure to press against the control surfaces, it helps to have some thrust vectoring from the LV-T45 swivel engines, which do have thrust vectoring. They have gimbaled engines. So that's why I'm using those on the lower stage boosters, even though their ISP is significantly worse. So I'll lose fuel, but I will have much better stability. Okay, where did I put... I think I deleted them, didn't I? I have to recreate them. There you guys are. Oh, really? You're just solid black. Huh. Sure. We don't have fuel lines. Okay, we're gonna have to be creative here. Don't have fuel lines. I think I'm gonna have to have... I think I might need to use thrust limiting to pace the fuel consumption of the engine. I might not even activate this until later. That could be dangerous on its own. That could be dangerous. Nope. I will activate it later, but I will not wait so long that the boosters are done. I'll activate it before the boosters drop. I'll just have to play it by ear and figure out when that's going to happen. Okay. Yeah, so fuel consumption rate. Let's set up the thrust limiting to be a little bit lower. And the timing of this will play into it a lot. They don't have angled, so we'll go with these. No struts, but we can probably auto strut to the root. Hopefully that'll be okay. Okay, make this a B, I guess. Is that the... that's the turnover of the album. That is the turnover, okay. Save. Okay. Let's flippy-dippy the CDDD. I don't know why I had to say it like that. Okay, we got Poem, we got Shamira, and we have Shamira bonus. I'm curious what's on the bonus. I don't remember what's on the bonus. It might just be instrumental tracks. All right, ejecto. Huzzah. So this is Delirium. Delirium is the artist. Shamira is the album, and we're listening to the bonus CD from that album. If you guys are at all curious to try to find this ancient relics of music. Play. What? There's only two tracks? Three tracks. There's only three tracks? Great, it's only one of these. Okay, that's fine. Didn't know these shortcuts existed. Oh, okay. Limit the amount of launches allowed per year. Ooh. I mean, for career mode, sure. Yeah, Space Eater. There's so many things this game needs. But screen is what... Okay, cool, cool. Do you know I have thuds? Ooh, you have thuds! Ooh! I'm gonna try it with just liquid fuel for now. We'll see what we can do with this. That should be okay. Oh, there's really something out there. Even that's a little bit fast. Let's tone down the throttle a little bit. These rocket launches are the one time in KSP where I really wish I had my joystick hooked up to the computer. Because continuously pressing right yaw, it just gets tedious after a while. I'm actually kind of surprised there's any lyrics on this bonus track. Usually bonus tracks are instrumentals. Oh, here comes that pressure. Okay, 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 hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on, stay up. No, 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 there it goes! Oh! Oh, man, that was awful. That was just awful. The hell? Holy mackerel. Okay, I have another couple of tricks up my sleeve. Wow. That was a doozy. Come on. Oh, you stupid little... Okay. Let me seal it up a little bit better. Okay. What are you up to in part counts? 60 parts. Good grief. Just to get one person into space. 60 parts. So far. Ay, ay, ay. And Sam, you did say you had some of the more aggressive fins, so let me put those back on. You're gonna need that extra stability. Holy macaroni. Okay. Take two. Take two, it's my rapping debut. I lived in England for a few years, and some of my friends over there introduced me to the really goofy band called The Midnight Beast. They do a lot of parody songs. Some of their old stuff is pretty good. Slow down, slow down, slow down. You're being way too aggressive here. Putting too much work into the fins, and if we are not pointed prograde, that Soyuz drag is just gonna... It's already appearing. It's already appearing. It's just gonna pull us right off course. We need to stay as prograde as possible. Prograde like pros. Hell, let me put it on prograde. See if that does anything for us. Nope, nope, nope. Too steep. We're going too shallow. Oh, we're already screwed. We're already badly screwed. Okay, fuel getting low, activating the Reliant. Oh, we're way shallow. I turned way too quickly. Oh. There they go. We're in the clear. Really shallow, though. I'm gonna tone this down. I don't want to be above 9. I don't want to clear 1,000 before I clear 30k on the ammo. Oh, there we go. We're above 1,000 meters per second. We're going way too fast. We're just wasting fuel now. Oh, that seems to have worked though. Oh yeah, torque ball for the win. I hate these new doors. I like the animation, I just don't like the doors. Okay, how are we looking now? Still right about the same. I think this is doable. I really do. I think we're good. Sorry. Yep. I'm clear. Not yet. Spinning rocket syndrome. Thuds. Okay, that's where I left off. Thuds part of the new SRBs. Bigger radial engines, yeah. They're radial liquid fuel burning engines. So it's just machine. Okay. Is it going to be unlisted as well? No, I'll leave it up. I wanted a clean break, basically. Center mass is too low. Really? Is that what it means? We did spin out with the boosters still attached, so yeah, there was a lot of engine mass down near the bottom. I figured it was probably more the case of the drag just being so far up that the torque arm was enormous. That was my impression of it. Earlier when I said one of these days... Let's make a taller rocket. Make a taller rocket. Aw, oh, come on, guys. I got it to work. Now you want to make a taller one? It's not tall enough, Inter. Get a little torque ball. Whee! And Jeb is now permanently stuck in orbit. Okay. Yeah, so these are the Thuds. These guys. Funny thing, whenever I think of the word Thud, I don't think of this engine. I actually think of the now called Hammer SRB. So every time somebody says Thud, this is what I picture in my mind. Actually, with the old skin. But this is the part that I picture. And then I have to think, no, wait, Thud is actually one of these things. It's a liquid fuel engine. It's kind of annoying. Tall Rock, I don't know, how much time do I have left on the stream? No, we're pretty much done. I think that's it. So, challenge complete, mission accomplished. I think that's pretty much it. Is there any mass difference between the different things? 77, 150, oh, there is. Ooh. Let me try it with a wait, are they different sizes? No, they're still the same size. Let me try it with a heavier top. Make that the end challenge here. Pomegranate, where did you go? There you are, okay. Okay, so now we have a heavier thing. I don't know, the Delta V seemed kind of okay, but I might add on some boosters. Just some little hop up off the launch pad kind of boosters. We'll see what the fleet can do for us. The launch pad cleaner crews must hate these things. God, no, not another flea! I had to pick up the debris from all over the rocket launch pad every time one of those things goes up. Not the stupid fleas! Okay, so ejectomatrons, you need to be over there. Thingy bobs, yes, likewise. You need to be down here with the other dude. Okay, and we'll save this as a C. Your capsule. Okay, so now mass is 44.5. So the shift was payload of 0.77 tons up to a payload of 2.27 tons. This, I do not expect to make orbit. I very much doubt this will see orbit. What's with the silence here? Delirium, what are you doing? Oh, did I pause it? How did I pause it? What? Uh-oh. Okay, music is just taking a dive. Ignore that. Okay, this will be the last launch of the stream. I do not expect this to make orbit at all. But the center of mass issue should go away, because having that much payload mass should definitely keep it high. I'm also curious if there's a difference in the amount of drag that the thing produces. I would imagine they all have the same aerodynamic drag, just because of their shape, but there's a possibility that the extra mass might play in? It shouldn't. I mean, that's not physics appropriate, but you never know. Alright, here we go. Yeah, this thing I do not expect to see orbit. Yeah, here we go. Fleas are already done. Oh, there are all of the... Why are you not... There we go. All the angry tech crews on the ground like, no, you didn't even get your flea debris clear of the launch pad area. Curse you. You realize how much cleanup I have to do after you guys? You blasted astronauts. Not my launch pad. It's been dented. Dented by fleas. Oh, here I am. See, I'm being too aggressive again. I've done a way too aggressive gravity roll. I'm just going to sit here for a minute. I should not have my orange angled marker, my bearing marker, should not be touching 60 degrees on the nav ball until I've passed 6 kilometers altitude, which I have just now. That's my rule of thumb for gravity rolls. And I got way, way, way too ahead of myself, and now the prograde is dipped way too low. There's the good old onion drag, even though it's not called an onion anymore, it's called a pomegranate. Oh, we actually have pretty good speed, though. I'm going to start reducing throttle and activate the Reliant. We actually have pretty good speed. This might be okay. If this thing makes orbit, I'm going to be very surprised. It should not. It really should not. But you never know. I mean, just having those little tiny fleas on there might have been a really huge boost. It might have looked like a small change, but it was a change. It might have been all the change we needed. Alright, passing 30 degrees at 30 kilometers altitude. That's my second rule of thumb marker. Not rule of thumb, that's a bad term. Guideline, my second waypoint. My mental piloting waypoint check. Pilot checks, there we go. Alright. Clearing the atmosphere, we're basically in space, essentially now. How are we doing? Wow! Holy cow! Are you kidding me right now? What? Oops. Seriously, this might actually work. Dastardly, oh, look at that. Ah, that's so cool. I like how each one of these capsules has a different lighting scheme. Nice amber colored lights here. Waiting for the flip. There's the flip. Would you look at that? And look how much fuel we have to spare to come back down. That is crazy. Dude, torque ball for the win. Torque ball! That is pretty cool. I'm happy. There you go, Sam. Challenge accepted and accomplished. Alright, and with that, I think I'm going to close the stream. I'll just read the final comments and close this out. Yeah. Yeah, true. That is true. All right, cool. Yeah, see you guys later. Have a good one.